A staggering blunder has seen hundreds of Sydneysiders given the COVID all clear when they were in fact positive. St Vincent's Hospital's pathology lab has apologised, saying it has raced to contact each person.
Human error on a scale that may well have serious consequences.
Owing to the very large volume of tests that we've been contending with at SIDPATH, last night we incorrectly messaged 400 patients who had been swabbed at our centres from December the 22nd and December the 23rd.
They were told they were negative to COVID-19 when they were not.
An emergency response team is now investigating the cause of this mistake, which is believed to be due to human error.
All of those people are now being contacted, among them 27-year-old Jimmy Nassif, who'd been isolating from his family before the all clear.
So me, mum and dad have gone to the bowling club together.
At lunch, a second message from the pathology company saying he was in fact positive.
Now potentially infected people at the bowling club, mum, dad as well. Dad's got heart disease, that's what I'm worried about.
Among the clinics SIDPATH runs, the drive-through at Bondi Beach, one in the city, Fairfield and Merrylands. The timing was never going to be good, especially after this warning from the health minister.
Bottom line here is that we would expect that pretty well everybody in New South Wales at some point will get Omicron. We're all going to get Omicron.
Case numbers were up again today to almost 6,400. Hospital admissions are up too to 458, although ICU numbers remain steady at 52.
There will be challenges. Let's not shy away from that. There will be challenges as we move through this next phase.
One of those, pressure on our health system with 2,000 staff isolating either as a COVID case or a close contact.
I've just been advised that yesterday managers were called in to cover overtime shifts. There are just not enough nurses to cover the vacant shifts.
I think this is time now to revisit what a close and casual contact is. Many of our members are being furloughed to find out they're negative.
The other pressure, testing queues. By around 10 this morning, they stretched for 1.5 kilometres at Rose Bay and around 1 kilometre long at Bondi Beach, Mona Vale Hospital and Narrabeen. But at Sutherland Hospital, the line was cut short hours before closing. Those at the back of the queue turned away early.
Well, it's extremely frustrating for people to essentially be turned back because the New South Wales government don't have enough resources in place. That's simply not good enough, especially in the middle of an outbreak.
The Premier's answer.
If you do not feel unwell, if you are not required to be tested and have not been directed so by New South Wales Health, or you are not travelling interstate and that is a requirement, there is no need to be tested.
And with tests now taking days to return, a negative result may no longer be accurate, as the person could well be positive by the time it's actually received. The answer, the Premier says, greater use of rapid antigen tests, now being acquired by the state government to hand out free. And for those who have tested positive, this clarification, don't expect health department advice to release you.
10 days after you have had your test, if you are symptom-free, you can leave your home.
But the requirement interstate for a negative PCR test is causing widespread hardship. This testing clinic at Coffs Harbour overwhelmed. Queues started at 2 a.m. 95% of those waiting here for tests to get into Queensland. And that's having a negative knock-on effect. This Gold Coast jet boat operator facing dozens of cancellations from Sydneysiders who can no longer travel because results haven't arrived in time.
For those people not to be able to come and having to cancel and get refunds, that hurts us.
Boosters are now the hot topic. The Premier touring the vaccination hub at Sydney Olympic Park. He was getting his third dose today, privately. But with the timeline reduced to 4 months after a second dose, the Commonwealth is providing 800,000 extra doses to top up existing orders for pharmacies and GPs. From midnight, QR codes are back for hospitality and retail, but if you're going into a shopping centre, you'll only have to check into the main venue, not the individual shops. And density limits of 1 person per 2 square metres are also back for hospitality, such as pubs, clubs, restaurants and cafes. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.
And Eddie Meyer joins me now. Eddie, 400 people have been given the wrong results. What are the ramifications of this pathology blunder?
Oh, Lizzie, it could be days before we start seeing the impact of this, but we do know that many of those people who received a false negative result last night were out and about with family, friends on flights interstate. And obviously the fear is they came into contact with the elderly and vulnerable while infectious. We also know that pathology labs are under stress, and that means they're not infallible. But in this case, there are many more questions that SIDPATH needs to answer in coming days, Lizzie.
OK, thank you, Eddie. Well, South Australia has scrapped mandatory pre-arrival PCR tests for travellers to help ease the load on testing clinics. The state recorded 774 new cases today, a new record, prompting new restrictions. From midnight, home gatherings will be limited to 10 people, down from 30, throwing New Year's Eve plans into disarray.